Eric, back of the naturopath. Thanks for coming back. We're going to talk about sulfur. So sulfur is a very important mineral. It's an important compound when it comes to bones and skin and hair. Many of your parts of your body require sulfur, you know, for them to be in good shape. So sulfur is found in many protein foods. Cysteine and methionine are two amino acids that are high in sulfur. You also find a lot of dietary supplements, you know, Alpha-Lipoic Acid. Many amino acids blends, of course, will have cysteine or methionine in it. MSM, glutathione. So many of these contain sulfur. But go to Google and have a look at supplements that contain sulfur, foods that contain sulfur. For example, brassicas like cauliflower, collards, onions. Sulfur is found in a lot of foods, Brazil nuts, almonds. Now, for the majority of people, sulfur is not really going to affect them that much. Now, for people with really bad SIBO, and I've seen lots of shockingly bad SIBO cases, their gas or farts can smell so bad it can knock over a bull elephant, okay, like seriously offensive gas, a hydrogen sulfide smell, because the sulfur can convert to sulfates or hydrogen sulfide in the gut due to the bacteria that are really not working properly. So my dad had a problem with this for many, many years. He had seriously bad SIFO and SIBO. He had small intestinal fungal issues and small intestinal bacterial. He was always going to the gastroenterologist for examinations. He could never work out why his gut played up, in spite of the fact that he could eat 25 or 30 ginger nut cookies, you know, and then a gallon of like chocolate milk and then be farting like a horse. Some people are like that. They don't understand why they have a problem, but yet, you know, the problem's right in front of their face. So if you have got very offensive gas, particularly like really offensive, and people are making a lot of, you know, noise about the wind, if you get my drift, then you need to do something about it and have a really good look at the sulfur-containing foods in your diet and chop out the top sulfur-containing foods, because that is particularly the protein foods, because that can temporarily really reduce that smell, can take it right down. Probiotics will certainly help. But also identifying what you've got in that gut in terms of bacteria through breath testing or stool testing to identify the target species, eradicate them, clean them up, get the diet sorted, low sulfur diet, and you'll be in a lot better space. Don't forget to click on the link in the description box if you want my free report. Thanks so much for tuning in.